Hear the word of the Lord, O Egypt, now is the time. I have seen your burdens and your pain. I have felt the struggles that you have endured time after time. Throughout the generations, you have sought to feel my presence, and I am in your midst, saith God. But it is time that you rise up with boldness and with power to let go of the fear. I understand that these are dark days and there are many who seek to devour you, but the Lord says that he is with you. So now is the time, army of God. In Egypt, Jesus is moving. Cower no more, saith God. Rise up, fear the Lord and only him. Depart from evil, give him glory, for the time of his judgment has come. There will be a day where God will judge the living and the dead, and his presence is moving in Egypt. My friends, Christians throughout Egypt, I want to speak to you today and encourage you. God sees your pain. He knows exactly where you've been. He sees what you have endured. But now is your time to rise up and to be a voice for this generation. We are living in the last days. We are living in those very moments before his return. And so if we are to have his power, if we are to walk in boldness and without fear, if we are to be filled with his glory, we must do it now more than ever before. I understand the city streets are filled with a pressure to conform to a different type of religion and to a different society, but we are to be the examples. We are to be the difference makers. We are to be the hand of God. We are to be that voice that speaks life. We are to be the light shining in the midst of darkness, to be the salt of the earth. Fear no more, saith God. Rise up, O Egypt, hear the word of the Lord. His presence is moving, and now is the time. Prophesy over this land. For thousands of years I have been in your midst, saith God, and I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. I took Joseph into your lands and made a people out of his seed. I brought the power of God into this land when you were under burden and under the power of Pharaoh. But I took you out of this land and I made you a people that is born of a spiritual seed that belongs to a spiritual Abraham. But the power of God can endure throughout all generations, and you are coming from something that comes from me. The second Adam is here. Jesus is returning, and you have to hear his voice today. Egypt, now is the time to rise up and to preach to this Muslim community. We are impressed, as we have been here, Christians from a foreign land in this land of Egypt. We have been impressed with those Muslims that so diligently practice their religion 5 times a day in prayer, and yet Christians are so afraid. 5 times a day in prayer, and yet many Christians around the world struggle to even pray for 1 hour. 5 times a day, and yet Christians around the world are so lazy. And we see marks upon the heads of the Egyptians as they diligently devote themselves to prayer. And yet, where are we Christians? We don't even get on our knees. We don't even find ourselves by our bedside or in our prayer closet. Jesus said, go into the closet, shut the door, and get lost with God. To be found in him is to be lost from the world, to be found in him, to be held in his arms, to be kept by his light and through his purpose. And yet we don't do it. We are taken aside by every single thing in this world. And yet we are so afraid to run to Jesus and let him take everything. We don't want to surrender our sin. We don't want to surrender our life. We are supposed to be that living sacrifice called for such a time as this. Do you see this land around you, barren and desolate, in need of water, and yet we as a people of God are so thirsty, and yet we're not asking for the rivers of life. We're not asking for a drink from the fountain and the well of life. Jesus can pour out and manifest and overflow your soul with his presence, and yet we don't do it. Why? Our sin tastes too good, and we're afraid to walk away from the world. We're afraid to let go of the things that we no longer need, because we don't trust in God to give us the things that are true, that truly our soul desires. Repent, Egypt. Repent throughout the world. Let your voice be heard. Stand up for what is good and what is right and what is holy. Now is the time. Let us prophesy over this land that rivers of living water would flow forth, and we would see a multitude saved and won into the kingdom of God. Moses brought the people of God out of the land of Egypt into a place that was promised. But Egypt, Egypt, oh Egypt, God is wanting to bless you. He's wanting to pour out his presence and bring this land into his love. And within his soul, he will give you everything that you need. He will pour out the purpose that you are longing for. But you have to stand up and be a light in this time. The desert sands are crying out for the love of God. Even the rocks are crying out for the glory of God. And it is your purpose to do that which he has called you to do. Now is the time. If my people in Egypt which are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then will I hear from heaven, forgive their sin, and heal their land. God is talking to you today. Do you hear his cry, Egypt? Repent, for the kingdom of God has come near to you. Hear the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Let every valley be exalted, and every mountain and high hill be made low. Let the crooked places be made straight, and the rough places plain, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and our eyes will see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken, and Egypt, rise up. Now is your time.